Looking forward to the season premiere of Downton.
I am, yeah, can't wait. I feel very honoured to be here, actually, yeah. Excited.
Are you a fan of Downton? Are you a fan of period drama, that kind of stuff?
I am, yeah. I really like Carson, yeah, my fave.
Why is Carson your fave?
Why do you think? No, he just is. I love his character so much, yeah, so he's one of my favourites, yeah. I've got my album coming out, so I've been recording that, and it's out on the 29th of this month. So, and the my advert will actually be TX'd right before Downton Abbey starts, so people will be able to see that and Downton at the same time, so, yeah.
What can we expect from the album overall?
It's a journey of, it's kind of like a night at the opera, and it's very much kind of like an emotional and passionate journey that I'm taking the audience on, and I think that they can relate to like memories and things like that. So it's staying away from the classical crossover just now, so very, very how I were on was on BGT. Yeah.
Is there a particular track on the album you're most excited for fans to get to hear?
There's quite a few, actually. One of my favourites is Song to the Moon, and another one is Umbel D from Madame Butterfly.
Are we going to be hearing you live anywhere soon?
You just missed me singing at the Royal Albert Hall with Catherine Jenkins, so that's been, but I've got a few concerts lined up, and I've got a tour with Collabro in January, so we're going to do a lot of collaborations, and so I'm very excited about that.
Started working with the boys yet?
We actually start working together tomorrow, so yeah, so that should be fun. Really excited, because we're all really pretty good friends, best friends in fact, so yeah.
When we spoke to you at the Diana anti-bullying event, obviously that's such an important cause for you. Can you talk a little bit about why that's so important for you and kind of how you've kind of dealt with that side of your life?
Because I went through a lot of troubles, and I know how children feel, especially at this crucial age when they are, you know, being given an education, which therefore, you know, sets them up for life. And if they are not having that, because they're too scared to go to school or being bullied, you know, it's a long time at school. And I just think they need to, you know, children are our, you know, future. They're our next generation, and they need encouraging. So, and you know, I never had that, so I think it's really important to keep on and make sure they feel happy at school.
How much has the support of fans of BGT and classical music meant to you, and kind of the confidence it's now given you?
So much, because, you know, I was a quivering wreck in my first audition, but now I'm really confident, and I think that's only with the love and support of, you know, people that have supported me, the public, and also like Simon Cowell and people who said, you know what, you need to just put the past behind you and smile. And I have been smiling, and I've got a record contract, and I think it's just making me believe in myself a lot more. And I think that's what's important, to make children believe, you know, that they can do stuff like this as well, whereas I thought I couldn't, but you can.
Have you got a message for fans before you leave us?
Thank you so much for your support. It's been, you know, it's done so much for me confidence-wise, and, you know, I love you all, and I hope you like my album.